What is up, guys? We are here on Pokemon Challenge. It's finally time for my ITL match. I didn't upload week 1 where I lost a pretty close game to my buddy Sebastian. Didn't save the replay because I was super busy and didn't have the time to upload anyway. It was a pretty good game though. Came down to the wire and I'm 0-1 now and I'm facing one of the best players I know on the Heat Lord, like young MV here. It's my boy Nyandroo, aka Andrew Andy. Pretty cool guy. He has a YouTube channel now, so definitely look him up. And we're both pretty threatening teams in my opinion, and like we both like always bring some heat and super fun to play. And like it's the most hype match in Gen 7 I had at this point. I'm super hyped for that. Obviously we already played, but that should not be like a factor yet. Looking at my team, I bring Big Black Huron Black with the ICMZ Freeze Shock. I'm 4 attacks with HP Fire, Fusion Bolt, Ice Beam, and obviously Freeze Shock. HP Fire was mainly there for Escavalier, which 2 hit KOs in combination with the ICMZ Freeze Shock. I bring a bulky Snorlax with Pursuit, Return, Earthquake, and Protect. Leftovers Protect to like just Scout for Scarf or Specs Mons and like get Leftovers back. I bring Sandrush Drill on the Air Balloon. I'm contemplating really if I should go with the Partial Berry, if I should go Chopal, if I should go Shuka, if I should go Balloon. I might decide with Partial Berry. X is the Earthquake, Iron Head, and Salt Stance. I bring Tapu Fini, Dual Step, Surf, and Moonblast with Defog, and I think Nature's Madness. Defensive Arcanine with Intimidate, Flamethrower, Will-O-Wisp, Morning Sun, and Raw, which could come in handy. I felt like if he wants to set up with Magearna, especially defensive, I think, to like check Magearna because like Magearna can't really touch it. Aura Sphere, which do like 36% if he's modest. And I bring a bulky Gigalith to set up the sand, Smooth Rock, obviously, with Rock Blast, Earthquake, Stealth Rock, and Toxic. I basically brought it because I didn't want to bring Scarf Moldbreaker Drill, which would have been just as fine looking at his team. Definitely would have been a very smart choice to bring, but I needed a rocker anyway. I didn't feel like bringing Azef or bringing rocks on Excluder, so Gigalith, my boy here, Marcellus, had to come anyway, and it checks like some of his mons. Like it's a decent switch into Nihilego, for example. Can even take a Draco from Ladi and shit like that, so not too concerned about it. My opponent brings Magearna, obviously, maybe an Assaultus variant or Specs or anything, and Greninja, which if it's a Specs or Life Orb variant could really hurt my team. Life Orb, like mixed Life Orb would probably be the best with like Gunshot and shit. I really expect Water Shuriken on it because Excadrill in the sand would be like a really big threat in late game, and Water Shuriken obviously would get rid of the potential Passive Berry, which would allow me to live a Hydro Pump. Rotom Heat, which I expect to be scuffed, but it's actually like a more defensive set as a check to Excadrill, I think. And Briggs Auroras, not seeing it in team preview, I know it's a hail setting set with Blizzard and probably Scarf to like be a late game check to my Excadrill if you like get some damage up on it. One Blizzard does obviously not kill, but like just resetting the Sandstorm to hail is very much in his favor. Nihilego, which is definitely a Stealth Rocker, and Ladi, which can do a bunch of shit with me, so I'm like, I wasn't sure like what set he wants to bring, but I decided to lead off with my Snorlax because he has nothing that can break it turn 1, which is really really good, and he leads off with his Greninja. I just go for the Protect here to scout if he has the Low Kick, which would do like slightly over 50%, but he just reveals to be U-turn, which I think is probably like Specs or Scarf at this point. Probably Specs because Scarf does not make any sense at all versus my team because I don't have a mon that is faster than Greninja anyway, and besides Rush Drill, which he does not speed with the Scar Variant anyway, so probably Specs Greninja here. Just for the U-turn on turn 1, as I fight, just fight off a return, I think. I could have gone for the Earthquake, but it's fine, I guess. That's a Z-mon, so it definitely could have the All-Out Pummeling, but I know it does not kill my Snorlax here, which is fine, so I will just go for the yeah, he goes for the auto sphere, so I just fire off an Earthquake, and on next time I will protect, seeing if he like wants to go for the all-out pummeling now, because like I already stayed in, and from this range it would actually have a shot at killing me, I think. So this time I will go for the protect, as he makes the play and goes for the all-out pummeling on a mon that like I already revealed Protect, and he was like, yeah, I'm pretty stupid for doing that. That's 18% 3D Protect, which is great for me. Like, now McGinn has Hard Wall. I think I just fired another Earthquake here. No, I switched out into my Arcanine, exactly, because like I didn't want to like allow my Snorlax to get too low. Got out into my Arcanine here and fire off a Will-O-Wisp now just to get some chip damage off and stuff, getting rid of like leftovers damage. He just wall switches out, does absolutely nothing, so I know this is not an offensive set. Probably is kinda speedy, but not super speedy because I outsped, and goes out into this Greninja, which now here goes for the Hydro Pump on my Feeny. That's 38%, like this is a fuck ton, and this is definitely a choice Bex Greninja. Good to know at the moment, but like a little bit too much damage in my opinion. Yeah, I can just go for the Surf, I think. Don't want to go for the Moonblast because the noise locked in. And catch the Nihilego on the switch in, which is pretty good, I think. Like, it covered like every option. It covered the Magiana switch in, and it covered like the Nihilego switch in. If you stayed in, like, so be it, you cannot break me with the Hydro Pump anyway. You can just like Moonblast the next turn or go for these. For the Nature's Madness or something, and he would never like bring Latios in on my type of Feeny, because like what does Latios do back? Exactly nothing. He doubles out, makes a very smart play, goes back into his Greninja, which obviously is a threat on my Snorlax. I would just go for the Protect again to see what attack he wants to lock himself into, I think. Yeah, just go for the Protect. He makes a smart plan, doubles out into Rotom instead of going for the U-turn, which like would be giving me a lot of momentum. I just go for Protect again because I want my Snorlax to be very healthy here and get a bunch of HP back every turn as he goes for the Volt Switch. And here I make a super stupid play. Even though I know he's not locked in, gauging from the damage on my Arcanine, I decide to stay in and let him hit me with the Will-O-Wisp, which is super stupid. I forgot like that the Misty Terrain disappeared from the field. Super dumb play, and now my Snorlax is burned, which sucks tremendously because now I can't get lefties back, and like every damage he gets, I mean, like now will put me more in range for any attack. I would just go for the return here, expecting to Volt Switch out, but that was a stupid play. This leftovers Rotom, so that's kind of cool. On next turn, I Earthquake, expecting him to switch out actually. Because like Rotom cannot touch me, like Leafstone would do jack shit and just like withdraws instead of Volt Switching out. I get that play because like Excadrill was kind of a smart switch in at this point, I think, because like it could probably not revenge it with anything, but like it would stop Volt Switches and then like allow me to pivot around and shit. So it just switches out into Magiena as I go for the Earthquake, predicting that, and now I switch out into my Arcanine on the, what does it go for? I think an RS V8, where he just wants to get damage off on me. I will Morning Sun up here, because Sand is not up yet, or Hail, and I can like just get damage back. On the next turn, I will just go for the Flamethrower, trying to revenge it, but he makes a smart play, goes into the Latios, so a lot of good like switches on both sides, I feel like, predicting each other, seeing what they want to do. And now I go into my Type of Feeny because of Chase Latias, I can still take two Psyshocks from a Life Orb attacking set. But he's actually a trick set with the Choice specs, which is fine. Like, he gets Leftovers, which obviously sucks because I'd like to have Lati low, so that I don't have to set up with Drill to get a sweep, but still fine. So he gives me the Choice specs here, and I think I will just go for the Moonblast on the next turn. So he goes into Magiena and sacks it to my Type of Feeny. So I'm up 6-5, now Magiena is out of the way, which wasn't a super big threat, but definitely sucked as he goes into his Nihilego. Had I locked myself into the Surf, I definitely would have stayed in here because I know he wants to set up rocks now, but sadly I can't. I go into my Snorlax here just to like take any special hit if he decides to go for the Sludge Wave. I think it covers every play he wants to do. Like, if he goes for Stealth Rock, so be it. I can still defog later with my Type of Feeny. And here I go for the Pursuit to get enough chip on the Nihilego to 2 KO with the Moonblast potentially. Yes, the Latios here, I will just go for another Pursuit. Maybe, like, seeing if he wants to. Oh no, I go for a return on this play, okay. kind of play going for pursuit here, but like if he brings Latios in, he does not want to switch out on the next turn, I'm pretty sure. Gets a Spadefro, which kind of sucks, because now I can't stay in and go for like more returns or pursuits. So I have to switch out into my Gigalith, with in the sand, can take every hit Latios wants to go for. You see, like, Psychic does 25%. I will just set up my rocks here, I think. Contemplated going for the Toxic, but I didn't want, like, Rotom to come in. Toxic on Greninja would have been really fine, because, like, the chip damage would put it in range for some attacks. But, I can just tag my Snorlax here. Like, it has done its job. Had a very, very solid game. And we'll go down here to the next Dark Pulse. I have no reason to switch out. I could potentially go out into Tapu Fini, preserving this as fodder, but I didn't feel like it. I don't think it was necessary. And now I can just go into my Kyurem. Specs Greninja does not kill with the Dark Pulse. Obviously, knowing my luck, the flinch would like be really unfortunate, because like that would make my Kyurem absolute useless, because I don't have a Roost or anything. But I know it can't, like, He cannot kill me with the Dark Pulse, and Sub-Zero Slammer with the Freeze Shock is 200 base power. It actually does 83% to 98% to the Greninja, and I will just go for that here because it will kill everything that wants to come in. Even like Auroras would take like over 50%. He decides to go into his Latios, sacking it, maybe predicting me to go for the Fusion Bolt, but that's none of my business. I just hit the Sub-Zero Slammer, which is such a cool move. And now I can go into his Nihilego and click Power Jam, and I think I predict that and go into my Excadrill, because like I don't really need to balloon. Looking at his team, like yes, Scarf Auroras could click Aura Sphere, but it doesn't kill even after the Power Jam damage. And now he's like has three turns left. I have two turns left of sand, and decide to like not set up, just go for the Earthquake here. So he goes into his Rotom. I still wasn't sure what his exact spread was. If he's max HP, max defense, Axes actually is a roll to kill this Rotom. I thought he would be like kinda speedy to outspeed some stuff, or like have mixed defenses to take on Cura, maybe better, like maybe live an Ice Beam from full or something. And I didn't want to risk basically my win con on the, like, to get Willowed or anything. I see, like, knows that I don't want to stay in here. Probably doesn't expect him to have access, and I go into my Cure because I know I can take any hit. I see he makes a very, very good plan, goes for the Electro Web. Pretty heat set on this Rotom. Had I gone for the Axes, I probably like would have gotten the kill, because the roll actually was in my favor. Depending on the set, he probably would have like a set that I killed with the Axes, because I know he had a little bit of speed investment probably. But didn't want to risk it, and if he goes for the Electro Web and on my Excadrill, that would be like very, very good for me, because like that allowed me to keep my Kyurem a little more healthy and maybe like use it a little bit better, because I could potentially defog rocks away if I need to. But he goes for Electro Web, very, very good play, expecting me to switch out. And yeah, my Kyurem now is at minus 1 speed. Now he's brought him actually 100% outspeeds me, because I don't pick too much speed on this thing, I think. Maybe I have enough for Crocodile, but I'm not really sure. I don't remember my set at all. It's been a while since I prepped. But yeah, we'll just go for the Earthquake. I don't want to cover both the Greninja switch in, as well as Rotom staying in. Terra Bolt, Earth Power is an easy 2-hit KO, so that's kind of fine. He goes for the Will-O-Wisp to get some chip damage up. And he, like, we both are just sacking our mons here. I could get in like whatever I want on the next turn, and like Kyurem is not useful anymore, because everything on his team revenges it, because of everything outspeeds. So yeah, I can just go into my Mia Wallace here. He is at minus 2. I take the chip damage to revenge it, because like I want to lock myself into Moonblast, because I don't want Greninja to come back. Obviously this Leaf Storm puts me in range for a Hydro Pump crit again from the like Greninja, but now he goes into his Auroras. I know he will go for the Blizzard or the Freeze Dry. Goes for the Freeze Dry. I still think, knowing that it's Hail, I still think it's Scarfed. It makes the most sense. And I will definitely scout for this here by going for the Roar, I think. But he switches out. I know I outspeed Tim at max speed Auroras, but if he's Scarfed, like So be it. So I roll him out as he switches out into his Nihilego, which is pretty good for me because Nihilego now is in range for every attack I want to go for. Just fodder after taking rocks, it will be at 4% or 3% turn it comes the next time. And I get him back into Auroras, which is great because I get needed chip damage off on this. And because I want to know if it's Scarfed, I don't want to go out into my Gigalith, because like a double into Greninja would be super whack for me. If I go into Gigalith, I would have to sack him on. So I just decide to stay in, and he reveals to be Scarfed Ancient Power. Thankfully it doesn't get the boost, but it doesn't really matter. I can now go into my Gigalith, get the sand back on, and like revenge plan anything. He has to save his hail, because otherwise he would just lose to Excadrill. Sex Nihilego, which is obviously the best play. And now he goes back out into Auroras. Yeah, I could potentially stay in, but I don't live a Blizzard without sand, so if he goes into Blizzard, goes for the Blizzard and kills my Gigalith, that would be like fine, because I still like... No, that would not be fine, because I can only revenge kill him on the next turn then with the Excadrill, and Greninja would sweep me with the Hydro Pump, because after Rocks, Tapu Fini would be in range for that, and I would have to bang on him missing Hydro Pump. So I have to sack my Tapu Fini here, which is fine, as he will just go for the Blizzard. And on the next turn, like, now this game, like, I basically have to game one here, because I can go out into my Gigalith here. I have two plays. I could get double out into my Excadrill, because, like, he has to switch out, like, he has two plays to win. He has to switch out into Greninja to like be able to reset the hail. But if I go for the Stonish or the Rock Blast, Greninja will go down to every Stonish or to three or more hits of Rock Blast plus Sandstorm damage. Even like two hits plus Sandstorm plus Rocks have a chance to kill him, I think, because I have quite a bit of attack investment. My plays are staying in and going for the Rock Blast, or staying in or switching out into my Excadrill, expecting him to switch out into Greninja, which basically is the play he should make. But the reason why I click Rock Blast is I win the game if I get more than two hits, 100%. I have a chance to win the game if I get two hits. So I didn't want to switch out into Excadrill if he decides to go for the Blizzard in the sand, actually hit it, and then sweep with Water Shuriken, Specs Water Shuriken. So I decide to stay and go for the Rock Blast, which basically wins me the game anyway, as he makes the switch out into Greninja. So if I had switched out into Excadrill, I would have won the game 100%. Like, that would have been an easy game, unless he gets like 5 hits with Water Shuriken or anything. But I didn't want to be weak to Water Shuriken. I go for the Rock Blast, yeah, now it kills the Greninja first, but I miss. And that's super bad for me. That basically loses me the game here. In hindsight, I probably should have doubled out into Excadrill, but like, the Blizzard plus Water Shuriken still has a better chance of winning him the game than me, than the chance of me missing Rock Blast. So hindsight is always 20/20, but I think I made the safest play possible here. I didn't want to stunt on him, like, on turn 38. But I missed the Rock Blast here, 90% accurate move, which would have killed him with 3 hits plus Sandstorm, 100%. Especially if he was hasty or anything, which I don't know. But, yeah, would have gotten the kill here, unless I got 2 hits, probably. But even then I had a chance to kill him. And now I have to switch out into my Excadrill because I need the sand. I'm hoping he would miss Hydro Pump, but nah, he hits his Hydro on this turn and on the next turn, obviously, like, to kill my Gigalith here. So I lose 2-0. I felt like I played this game really, really well. Probably could have preserved Snorlax earlier as fodder, which like probably like would have helped me to have like more sacks and reset the sand and shit, but still would have come down to doubles I made, or if he had Water Shuriken on the screen ninja and stuff like that. So hindsight always 20/20, but I think the Rock Blast miss really, really cost me here. I still would agree that doubling into X-Crew would be 100% the play, because it guarantees me the win if he switches out. Like, it would, like, unless obviously he has these specs, Water Shuriken. I wasn't sure at this point. I felt like Water Shuriken is a fantastic move on specs to Ninja, even if it's not like Ash form, just because I have the sand. I have stuff that is weak to water, like potentially like Arcanine even, or like just the Gigalith or the Excadrill, which like could potentially like revenge kill Greninja with a Wild Charge Arcanine in this case, if I'm a Scarf variant or anything, which actually doesn't have a bad matchup versus him. So I felt like Rock Blast was 100% to play, because the chance of me hitting the Rock Blast and killing him were higher than my chances if he had the Water Shuriken to win the game. So hindsight always 20/20, but I lose this match sadly. Felt like I played this really well, probably one of my better played games in this last couple of weeks. I haven't been on top of my game, obviously, even though I felt like I outplayed most of my opponents, but yeah, kind of sucks that I missed the Rock Blast, but that's the game we play. Thankfully, it was against a very good friend of mine, my boy Nyandroo, so I'm not like salty at all. It was like unfortunate in the heat of the moment. Obviously, like, you don't want to lose because you miss a Rock Blast, but yeah, if you don't want to miss, like, use, I don't know, ancient power or shit, like, just like he did on this Aurora's bed. Nonetheless, I start 0-2, but it's a 13 league week, so nothing to worry about. I think I have a very, very good matchup next week. Play basically a team that is 13-0 by, or 11-0, I think we all have 11 months. It's 11-0 by Scarf, Moldbreaker, Excadrill, so that's kind of cool. But yeah, we'll see how that goes, and we'll see if I get back to a win here. And yeah, thank you guys for watching, and definitely go check out my boy Andy. Nyandroo is his Twitter and his YouTube, so definitely go and watch that. Leave a comment and a like if you enjoyed, and catch you next week.